From KWTX News 10, the Weather Authority, here's Rusty Garrett.
And welcome back, everybody. We'll get you the very latest on Hurricane Harvey in a moment. But first of all, let's check and see what we did today and what's going on out there tonight. We had enough rain cloudiness across our area to hold those temperatures well below average, which would be 96 for this time of year. And we had lows this morning in the lower to the mid-70s. The Waco Airport came in at less than a tenth of an inch. It is still showering a little bit out there. We've got one little cell in southern Robertson County, south of Franklin. A little bit of light rain out here around the Navarro County area. Most of this green is nothing more than just ground clutter from the radar site down in Granger. But we do see some pretty heavy downpours still going on, moderately heavy downpours going on across Bosque County between Clifton and Meridian. And there have been showers across northern Coryell into adjacent Hamilton County. Everything pretty much moving off to the west, a little bit out there in northern San Saba County. But I think most of this will be tapering off as we move a little deeper into the nighttime and early morning hour. So we'll just say scattered rain, mostly cloudy skies otherwise, and temperatures in the 70s with east winds. 40% chance for the next couple of hours, and we'll be back to a 40% chance with a mixture of sun and clouds tomorrow and a few of those little afternoon showers and thunderstorms. Now let's give you the latest on this still powerful Category 1 hurricane. It has not increased Cat 2 strength yet, but it is in water that is certainly going to support further strengthening over the next 12 hours or so. It will likely by this time tomorrow be well on its way from Category 2 to Category 3 status. Now, the eye has kind of been overshadowed by the thick clouds and thunderstorms around the center of circulation. Here's the latest on its path. As it's been so far today, making a pretty wobbly but steady progress to the northwest. Winds are still at 85 with Harvey. It is moving at 10 miles per hour and is sitting about 250 miles off the coast of Corpus Christi. Now, where's it going? Well, the track continues to take it right across the coastal plains, right up here to the north and northeast of the city of Corpus Christi over Mustang Island. And then it's likely to immediately start to diminish in strength. It will likely reach the coast sometime, probably very late overnight Friday or early Saturday morning. And then it will start to slowly weaken. But the problem is that it's going to just sit up here across the coastal plains, and it's actually going to do a little bit of a turn and could head out toward the southeast Texas area in and close to Houston, Galveston. And this is according to the hurricane tracking charts through Tuesday of next week, Tuesday evening at that. So this entire area of the coastal region of Texas will no doubt be drenched. And as you've heard, catastrophic flooding is likely. All of this white contoured area could easily see 15 to 25 inches with isolated totals as high as 35 inches. Now, this hopefully is the worst case scenario for our area. Across our northern counties, more than likely 1 to 2 inches of rain, but when you get down to the central I-35 and especially points south, we could easily see 3 to 5 inches of rainfall. So prepare this weekend and into early next week for at least the possibility, the threat that some of this could result in some flash flooding in our area. So that's the way the forecast is shaping up for the impacts of Harvey. For tonight, just a few scattered showers and then about a 40% chance for some afternoon and evening showers and thunderstorms tomorrow. The big question marks remain around the weekend. So right now we're saying 60% chance for showers and thunderstorms, tropical rain bands that'll be pushing up from the coast and likely continuing through Monday but tapering off by Tuesday. We will certainly be watching this closely. The Hurricane Center comes out regularly with updates. Stay with News 10 online and on the air, and we'll keep you updated, guys.